I know, you want to see the hot dog thing, and we'll get to that and more. But first, we want to look at how you can use the SawStop system to avoid junking out blades and cartridges. SawStop gives you a set of keys with the machine, and we use those to get in what's called a bypass mode. That lets us use the detection part of the system without triggering the blade break. After turning on the power, the red light will flash while the system initializes. Once the green light comes on by itself, we turn the key towards the back and hold it. The red light flashes once, and the green light starts blinking. We continue holding the key and pull the paddle out to start the saw. The red light blinks once more, and the green light continues to flash. That puts the system in bypass mode where it'll stay until the blade stops spinning. Remember, if we just turn the saw back on, the red light doesn't come on, the green light stays on solid because the detection and brake system are operative. We have to go through the key sequence every time to put it in bypass mode. SawStop just wants to make sure that you don't get into bypass mode by accident. When not using the bypass mode, take the keys out. You don't need them to do anything but get into the bypass mode. Some think that wet wood will trigger the brake system, and that's not necessarily true, especially if the wood isn't very wet. And watch my moisture meter as it comes down the board. If you're going to start messing around with wet wood, you never know how wet it is in any one given spot. That's why I just let the wood either dry out or I get dry wood. I ain't going to mess around with Mother Nature like that. We can put the saw in bypass mode and carefully make a cut to see if the saw can detect you through the wet wood. The saw didn't detect me, so theoretically we can arm the brake and go ahead and cut this wood. But remember, if we get to a very wet spot, it could fire the brake. Some think that just hitting a piece of metal within the wood will automatically trigger the SawStop brake, and that's not true. If you're touching that metal when it hits the blade, your signal could get transferred to the blade and initiate the braking. For this first cut, I have the bypass mode engaged. Because I'm not touching part of the nail, we can cut right through it and the bypass mode doesn't detect anything. This time the full braking system is armed and we'll cut through the nail again. If the bypass mode was right, nothing will happen. And we go right through, nothing happened. I wasn't touching the nail, so SawStop didn't see any change and didn't deploy the brake. Okay, here's the sausage thing. We've got the bypass mode on so I can run the sausage into the blade even though I'm touching it and nothing happened. And the lights are flashing on the switch box showing me that there was a detection. Now, real time with the full system armed. As soon as the blade touches the sausage, the blade's gone. Notice that the sausage moves just as the blade drops out of sight. That little bit of contact is all it took. This time I'll watch the cartridge from underneath the table. It's amazing how quickly this happens and it's all done. Now in slow motion, watch for the flash. That's about 1500 amps of electric vaporizing a restraining wire in 20 microseconds to release the spring. It's just flat amazing to me that they can make all of this happen in such a short time. We can see where we cut this sausage in bypass mode, but can't even find a nick where the blade touched it and deployed the brake. Human skin might be softer and got a little nick, but I can't imagine it being any more than a nick. This is the back end of the braking pawl that we just distorted. You can see how crushed this is. We'll compare it to a new one, and you can see there's a lot of difference. This took a lot of impact. Now with the bypass mode engaged, we're going to bring a sausage down onto the blade in about the same direction that my hand traveled in that kickback video we did before. And this isn't going to be pretty. I've seen pictures of injuries from this kind of contact, and this result isn't all that far off. Now, we'll try the same motion with the braking system engaged. And the difference is remarkable. The deepest part of this cuts right about 3/16 of an inch deep. We might need a few stitches, but not a replacement hand. And from below. And this is what the switch box looks like after the brake has been deployed. And this is the brake pawl after it saved us all that damage. You can see how deep the teeth went before they stopped and threw the blade down below the table. We can also see the major distortion in the back end of this brake pawl as well. So you're just going to hope you don't do nothing dumb and not get a SawStop? I think the SawStop version of this accident is going to be way easier to live with, but you decide.